Hello, hello, this is Cammy Comer, and welcome to episode 45 of Cammy Comer Plays Minecraft. And in today's episode, I got some plans. Hello? How do they keep getting through this portal? Oh, well. I have some plans. I am collecting some materials to go take a trip. Got something pretty technical plan for today, but we are in 1.6, and this plan involves horses. Yeah, I got some. I got these two here, and I actually have a lot more horses somewhere else. So that's where we're headed right now, but it's pretty far away, and I got this guy. I brought him back from where we're going, and I brought him specifically because he is... Oh, he's tied up still. But I brought him specifically because he's a really fast horse. And actually, I need to dump off something so I can bring the leads I have. And I don't remember where I put them. But yeah, where we're going is about 10,000 blocks away. And so we dug a tunnel there through the nether. And where did I put the leads? Okay, I lost them. But yeah, it's about, you know, 1,000 blocks in the nether, maybe 1,500, something like that. And, oh, hey, I was looking for those. But, yeah, that's where we're headed. And, man, I gotta get on the storage room too, clearly. But, yeah, let me find those leads that, oh, I know where I put them. I put them in here. Got the coal blocks all made up. We don't need quite so much redstone. Bring that with me. And let's head out. So what I'm going to be doing today is the spot that we found these horses, we found a lot of horses. And this guy is probably the worst jumper I've ever seen. But he does well on the speed test. But yeah, we found a lot of horses. And my goal is to set up a testing system so that I can get them all ranked up and, yeah, get that, figure out which horses are the best. So that is what we're doing today. And here's something I already learned about horses. They need a too wide tunnel like I have there and too high. But if you're riding it, you can get away with just digging out the one block up here. And, it's loading a little slow, but you can see I'm able to ride through here without taking my head off. So, yeah, it's down this way. That way is to the witch farm, right there. And the tunnels worked out well enough that I was able to extend the one heading over the dual blaze spawners in this direction. So that's the way we're going. And yeah, I'll meet you over there. Okay, this is the plains where Rom and I have been working. We built a horse enclosure there. It's nothing special, but yeah, this is, we are at negative 11,000. So it's a long way, but it was worth it because there were a lot of horses here. And yeah, there they are. I'm going to tie this guy up over here because he is the fastest horse I've found so far, in my opinion. I have a method of testing speed, but we'll get to that. But get out of the way, please. Got our gate here. It works. Yeah, this is how this is the number of horses we found in this plains biome. There are greater than 65, around 70, and I am going to be testing every single one of them. So yeah, what I gotta do is there's just a little it was a test case for a test setup for testing jumping. Test. But, we're gonna be setting up a jumping test. Something similar to this, but not exactly like this. I have to set up a speed course, so we're gonna set up a straightaway running course. And then, of course, the last test is, just HP, which you can tell just by getting on them. So, you know, I haven't done a whole lot of research on horses. I know that Some of them can jump 5 blocks high, so we'll have to test to that limit. The speed test, I have a really good setup in mind. I saw something similar to what I have planned on the Reddit, but this was something I came up with independently, and it will give us a very fine gradient on the speed. It will test them to tenths of a second, which is really nice. So we'll get that set up. I think we'll probably do a 100 meter test, and then of course the health numbers. So then we'll write all that on a sign and put a horse attached to each post, and we'll find out which of these horses are the overall best horses. So that's what I'm gonna get working on now. I think I'll set up the speed test right now, so I'll get to it and we'll be back. Okay, I got the 100 meter speed track fenced out, and now I'm just putting in the tripwire hooks. This will be our starting and stopping mechanism, so we'll just lay these out like this and string them up. Okay, that's good, like that. And then I need to bring the wire under the fence here, so brought a whole bunch of redstone. So we'll bring it underneath like that, and we're just gonna string it along here beside. I can go right here. So we're just going to lay it out like so, and I'll get some repeaters in here after, but what we need to do now is run this signal to a timing mechanism that will be approximately in the middle of the track. And I haven't built the timing mechanism yet, but I know exactly what it's going to look like. Built it in Creative, tested it out, works really great. I will recommend it to anybody who wants to test horse speed at any point. So yeah, I'm just going to run the line all the way down to the other end of the track. You can see, got it all laid out there. And we are going to -44.30 with this redstone. And that will be the 100 meters laid out. So right here, right here is where we will put the other... the other end of the line. So this will be the start of the track. I got extra laid out so that the horse can get a good run up to it. And we'll just lay that like that and like so. And we'll get our tripwire hooks on here. Whoops, that's not tripwire hook. Like that and like that. And I'll fence that out too. But so the plan is, start down here with the horse. I'll put a gate in at this end so we can get in. So we'll get in here. We'll take a good run up. We'll go through the tripwire to start the timer right here. The timer will start in the middle. There will be a little bit of repeater delay as the signal travels down the line to the timer. But that's okay because we'll then be running down. And when we hit the tripwire at the other end to stop it, there will be the same signal delay coming back, so it'll be like 3 repeaters plus a piston to start it and 3 repeaters plus a piston to stop it. So it should all work out relative to each other as long as, you know, we're doing the same thing, the same amount of delay at each end. So you know, even if I had, say, like a 100 second delay on the start and a 100 second delay on the end, as long as the delay is the same, you should still get an accurate time measurement. I don't think fences will cut that off, but I'll just lower that down anyways. So we got the start and stop line laid out, and now somewhere in the middle here, I guess right around 44.80 or so, right around here, I'll build the timing mechanism. So I'll get that built, and then we can start testing some horse speed. Alright, well, I got the timing device all built and set up, which was a challenge with an audience. Man, these zombies now. They're everywhere. But so how it works is the starter signal comes in to this block, which triggers this very simple monostable circuit. And that starts this clock here. which powers not one, but two droppers that will shoot items into this middle chest. Now, because this clock will fire at five rotations per second, and we're firing two droppers, we can measure time to exactly 1/10 of a second, which I think is a pretty... It's precise enough for what we're working with. So, we can't really get much more precise than that. And then, of course, when we get to the other end and stop it, the signal comes down this line up to this piston, which pushes this block down and breaks the circuit, and the clock will stop. So that's that. I just need to hook up the line coming from this end, and we'll do that very simply. I decoupled this line from the clock, so we won't be starting it, and I'll just, well, maybe I won't use that. I'll throw some dirt in there, and, okay, hello, you guys tracked me a long way, you're being annoying, I think we're gonna have to shoot you. Okay, so now I'll just, follow the line down with my repeaters, and... Oh, come on. Leave me alone. We'll get the power all the way there. So here. And that's not going to quite do it. Or will it? No, I think that will. That'll make it. So we needed only two repeaters to get here. Oh, jeez. I think it was just two. Yeah, one, two. Okay. And I'll avoid the zombies and get down to the other end and hook that up, and then we can run our first test. We'll run a test of the timing mechanism first to make sure... Whoa! Make sure everything's working okay there. So yeah. Jesus. We'll just do the same thing here after I shoot these guys. Oh my god. Man, I should have brought a bed. I don't know if there's any sheep around here. This is annoying, but yeah. We'll do the same thing. Throw that in there. And more of you, eh? Good god. Okay. Alright, let's get this done. Follow this down. One. Oop, that was too soon. Two. Leave me alone. Okay. One, two, and I don't think two's gonna make it on this side. No, it will not. Three. Okay, piston's down, we're good there. And I'll have to just add one repeater to the other side here so that we are consistent. And, holy crap. Alright, we'll just do... Oh, come on. Okay. Oh, this is getting on my nerves a little bit. Okay. I'll close this up. And we can see the clock in action real quick. We'll just make sure that I built it right. So we'll pick this up. Please stop raining. This is getting to be a little too much. And we'll connect this. And then, alright, so there's nothing in the chest. We'll go down here and we'll trigger this tripwire. Like so. That should have started the clock. Hopefully. No, it did not. Oh, it's because we still have this piston activated that is stopping the clock. Oh, thank God. Oh, okay. Right. Get rid of this. Run all the way back down. I got into Pearls. And finally get a look at this thing in action. Okay. So, start the clock. And that should be running, hopefully. Did I do everything right? Okay, we're running. And we're filling. Okay, perfect. So you see, that is firing very quickly, giving us a really, really nice, precise timing on it. So, we can... Well, I'll run down here. And I'll stop the clock, and we can finally, finally, test the horse. So I'll just get these droppers refilled, and we'll test the fast horse there. So we'll get the timing on him. Okay, give me all this. Full, and full. Give me that. Okay. Should be ready to run a test now. Alright. Wow, that took a while to set up. Okay. Oh, yeah, he's tied up. It's funny how those leads work. They just, you know, they just don't let you, really don't let you go anywhere. Okay. So, we'll get down to the end here. Yeah, this is a fast horse. The fastest one in my testing in creative that I was able to... Oh. You can't get through that gate, eh? And I don't think this guy is a good enough jumper to get over, even a one... Oh, okay. He could just make it. Okay. Here we go. The fastest horse I found in creative did 100 meters in 8 seconds. We'll see how this guy does. Okay, so it started. Clock should be running. It is. And we'll just go straight on to the end here. And stopped. And I should be able to just run through this without affecting anything. Okay. So, we'll see how he did. I think that was faster than 8 seconds. So it's 64 plus 12. That is 76, so that's 7.6 seconds. So that's fast horse. He did 100 meters in 7.6 seconds. I'm not sure if we can beat that by much, but let me grab the black one there, and I'll show you a little speed comparison. So we'll get our lead out here, tie him back up. And we'll get this guy. And, oh, I don't want to do that. Okay, I'm pretty sure this guy is significantly slower. Yeah, you can see it. He is much slower. So we should see a large difference in the time. So remember, we're looking at 7.6 seconds. And I'll line myself up here. And off we go. Time started, and this is probably going to be over 10, well over 10 seconds. This guy is slow. Okay, time stopped, and let's see what we got on this guy. Okay, we got 64, that's 116, 11.6 seconds for the 100 meters, so that horse... significantly faster than this one. So yeah, now it is time for me to do some testing, and I'll get some more test setups set up, and we'll be back again. Well, I got my testing methodology set up, and I'm ready to test this guy that I'm riding right now. I've tested 4 so far. Got their stats written down. I just gotta make sure that I... Okay, I gotta reset the timer here. Just do this manually. I don't think it was worth setting up, or would be worth setting up an automatic reset on that. Yeah, so, first thing first, I take the horse down to this end. Make sure I don't trip that tripwire on the way by. And, first thing we do, gotta get in here. I line myself up. And we do 3 runs of this. So Yeah, I've been doing three runs, not resetting the count in between. Ooh, a little lag spike there. And then I just divide by three to get the average. So then I just, yeah, can run back through because that doesn't affect the timer. I just gotta make sure I get to the outside here before I get to the end. And back in. There we go. So that was one run. Go run two. And most of these end up being the same for all three runs, but sometimes there's a little variation, so we'll have to see what happens with this guy. So that's run two. To the outside here. I should maybe make a better way to get to the outside, but that works for now. And back in. And we'll go run three. Like so. So yeah, this is working out pretty well, although the testing is a little slower than I thought. It's going to take several hours to get through all the horses, probably. That's alright. So yeah, there's three runs. And now I just get off halfway, count how many we got. So we got four stacks. 64 times 4, 256, plus 18, 274, divided by 3. That's 91.3, so 9.13 repeating is its 100 meter time. So yeah, they didn't get the same measurement every time. So I'll just leave that number in my calculator. And then I come over here and I got the jump test set up. So I have this starting at 1.25 meters and I go in quarter meter intervals with snow cover. So there's, you know, two snow cover, four, six, and then full block. So usually I've been starting at 2. Okay, he cleared 2 easily. So then I can move on to 2.25. And I'll go until I get the perfect jump. And as soon as they can't clear, then I go to the one below and I mark that one down. So we'll go here. Okay, over that, no problem. So now we are at 2.75. And he doesn't seem, I'll get one more perfect one. Yeah, he gets a 2.5 for his jump. So we'll come over here now. And this is where I've been keeping them once I'm done testing. So we come over here, take the saddle, get off, move these guys out of the way. Fence post, hook them up to it. And then I just put down a sign, and I think this guy was 12 hearts. Let's get on him once, just to make sure. 12 hearts. So we go 12, and we said 9.13 repeating. We'll give it like that, and he had a 2.5 jump, I think is what we said. So there, you can see, you know, we got guys with really bad jump here, but he's really, really fast. And then we got some with really low hearts. This guy jumps pretty good. So testing's working out. 5 tested, only like 63 to go. And then there's another plains near here with a whole bunch more horses. So I'm going to be testing for a good long while. And can you believe we found probably close to 150 horses in these two plains, not one donkey anywhere. So that's kind of disappointing. But yeah, I'm going to keep testing and we'll see if we get any super horses. Okay, I've tested 13 horses now. So things are moving along. It's taking a while, but it's going smoothly. You know, I haven't found any horse that's even close to as fast as this first guy yet. He did 7.6. Next closest is 8.2. He can't jump worth a damn, but he's quick. And, you know, it's so out of line with everything else right now that I feel compelled to retest his speed here. Just to make sure I didn't mess something up. So we're going to give him another go here. He can... Oh my gosh. Yeah, he's fast. He can barely jump over a fence, but he sure can move. Okay, let's make sure that the clock is reset here. It is not. Okay. throw these in. And it's kind of appropriate that I'm doing horse stuff right now because where I live here in Calgary, it's stampede time. Starts tomorrow. No, what's today? Today's Wednesday. Yeah, today's Wednesday, so starts tomorrow. It's kind of a, well, it's a Western exhibition and kind of carnival that runs for 10 days. So it's definitely Western themed. Got to get out my cowboy hat, which, yes, I do own a cowboy hat, and be wearing that around town for a few days. And yeah, go down to the grounds, get some good food, maybe go to the rodeo, some chuck wagon races, and it's a good time. And holy cow, I think this guy is just way faster than everything else. He is moving. So yeah, we'll get another 3-run average for this guy. And we're probably running out of time for today, but I'm really enjoying these horses. It gives me something to min-max, something to optimize in the game here, looking for horses that I can breed into, you know, kind of a super horse. So I'm looking for, obviously, maximum health, which I believe is 16 hearts. I'm not 100% sure on that, but we'll find out. Want the highest speed. Not really sure what the highest speed is, but this guy's got to be in the running for sure. And obviously the highest jumper, so we're looking for something that can go over 5 blocks. So let's check here. 64 times 3 equals 192 plus 34. 226, and divide that by 3, 7.53. So this run, actually, he came out a little bit quicker than I had him marked down for. So this guy, you know, not a jumper, but give him a straight line to run on, and man, can he move. So this guy will almost certainly be one of our breeding stock for when we get to breeding, but ooh, boy, is he ever quick. Yeah, we'll tie him back up here. And we may change the sign here. So he has 10 hearts. And he did the run in 7.53. And he can jump 1.5 blocks. Wow. Good work. And yeah, we'll get that saddle back. So yeah, we got a really, really fast horse. Haven't found anything that's too amazing of a jumper. I guess this guy with his 4.5, which guy is it? That guy in the back there. He's the highest jumper so far. And the most hearts we've seen is 13. But I'm fairly certain that there was a 16 hearter in there that I rode for a minute. So, yeah, I'm going to keep going with my testing, but I think we're going to end today's episode here. I'm not sure how long we'll spend on the horses. It might be a couple more episodes, but, you know, they're just such an amazing form of transportation that it's hard not to want to get a perfect horse. So that's what I'm working on for now, and hope you guys maybe learned something. That timer is a pretty neat contraption, I think. And, yeah, we'll see you next time.